Windows 8 Pro Tutorial 7, Using Metro Apps. Here in the start screen we have multiple Metro apps. The first setting is the live tile. And we see all these tiles here flipping around and showing different pictures and a bunch of other things. And this is getting kind of annoying to watch all this stuff. So I would like to turn off the live tile by right mouse clicking. I get a little check mark here. Then I'm going to go to turn live tile off. And now this flipping stops. So I'll just do this for all the tiles. I wish not to go around and flip at me. If I wish to turn the live tile back on, I can always right mouse click and click on turn live tile on here. I can also make the tiles larger or smaller by clicking on the tile and then selecting smaller if the tile is large, or right mouse clicking and selecting larger if the tile is small. So with Solitaire and Minesweeper, what I can do here is I'll just make these both smaller, and now I have more space on my screen. If, for example, a tile is deleted from the start screen, for example, the Microsoft Solitaire collection, I'll just unpin from start. If I wish to bring that back, all I have to do is right mouse click, go to All Apps, right mouse click on the Microsoft Solitaire collection, and click on Pin to Start. I'll hit the Windows key on the keyboard, and I find that the Microsoft Solitaire collection is over here, so I'll just click and hold and drag over next to the Minesweeper, putting it back in the same local area. And I can move any tile around by clicking and holding, as you just saw. For example, I could bring news over here, bring news back, and I can make my own little sections. For example, I could bring finance to a new section, and then also bring news, weather, and sports. So that way I have a little section here for news-related items. I can also move the sections around by clicking on more space, and then I can take the entire section and drag and drop as you see here. Depending upon which app is open will determine which settings we have. For example, I can click on the store. By positioning the mouse over to the right hand side and going to settings, I find that I have the settings for the store. I'll leave the store open and press the Windows key on the keyboard, going back to the start screen, and I'll go to the desktop here. I'll position the mouse to the lower right hand side and go to settings. And here we have the settings for the desktop. I'll leave the desktop open, hit the Windows key on the keyboard, and I'll go to weather. And by positioning the mouse in the lower right hand corner, I can bring up the settings of the weather application. But also by right mouse clicking here within weather, I can go to places. Instead of seeing London, England for the weather, I can always add and change the city. So now by clicking on the places here, I now have the weather for Boston, Massachusetts. I'll go ahead and press the Windows key on the keyboard, go back to the start screen. And by positioning the mouse over the upper left-hand corner, we find that we have weather here. If I position the mouse to the lower section of the line here, we'll find the desktop and the store that are still open. So I can go back to the store if I wish to. Then I could go back to weather. Then I could go back to desktop. And so on. If I wish to multitask, what I can do here, so I'll just bring up the store, and I'll position the store to the left-hand side by clicking and holding. Now we have the store here and the desktop here. I can also bring in weather and position it to the right-hand side. So now I have weather here in the desktop here. I can adjust by clicking and holding, moving the apps around.